how to make an external BGP peering between an OpenBSD machine and a Cisco router. On this slide, we have the syntax for OpenBSD with the corresponding one for Cisco. First, let's see how easy it is to install OpenBSD. I am using VirtualBox to show the boot process from the install CD. As you can see, the installation is very simple and with few options. This is the phase where we assign the IP address to each interface. I leave the defaults for this partitioning. Let's jump to the final to speed up this demo. Now we are going to configure rc.conf.local to make this BSD machine a BGP router. From rc.conf you can activate various applications and protocols. On our case, we select the BGP line. We only have to change where is the node with quotation marks. Let's configure BGP, the autonomous system number, the network we want to advertise, the IP address of the NIC board with corresponding autonomous system number. On this original bgpd.conf, we can see various configurations examples and best practices. Let's create a new one for our configuration. AS65002 for this autonomous system. The network from interface EM0. /24 network and the NIC board that is direct connected to the EM1 interface. You can see from the above drawing the corresponding address. Config file has errors because only root may have read and write permissions. After any change on bgpd.conf, we need to make a bgpctl reload. Let's put TCP dump on TCP destination port 179 to see if the Cisco tries to establish a connection. Now on Cisco we paste the previous copied configuration to speed up this demo. You can see from below that the results from Cisco trying to connect the OpenBSD box. You can with the show IP BGP summary to check the state of the connection is still in native state. Wait a moment. Now the NIC bar is up and we can see one prefix received. With BGPCTL show rib, we have the same information as on Cisco with show IP BGP, the BGP routing table. As with show IP BGP summary on Cisco, BGPCTL show rib summary gives information of NIC bar states and prefix received. One last step that I want to mention is how to change the IP address of the interface. This information is on etc hostname.interface. In our case, hostname.em0 and hostname.em1. The netstart command will update the IPs from these files.